we're going to be filleting this codling, and I'm more than likely going to probably use one side of it and do some battered fish, some homemade chips, maybe do some mushy peas with it. The other fillet, the other side, I'm not 100% decided yet, but I may do something like fish fingers, just something like that. So anyway, what you want to get yourself is a nice sharp filleting knife. This one is the one I normally use for filleting, but as you can see, it's not going to be wide enough to get through the cod. The blade's too short. So I've got this other filleting knife here, a Gerber, which has a built-in sharpener. This one will be perfect. This is actually a really good knife, and I think it's only around £8. It's cheap, it's flexible a little bit, which is what you want. It's not super flexible. If I show you from there, you can see it's got a bit of flex in it, but it is a bit of a stiffer knife, which is what I prefer. Anyway, I'm going to gut this fish first to show you how to do that. Basically, you've got the hole here. So what you're going to do is just come along it. Keep the knife as flat as possible to the fish, look, like that. If you go in at this angle, you're going to puncture all the guts. You want to try not to. So keep it as flat as possible. Watching your hands and keep your fingers out the way. And come along it like this. As you can see there, all the guts are wanting to come out. Grab it at the top, and if you fold it that way towards the head end and pull it all that way, all you will have to do is here is slice there, which is basically the stomach. If you slice that off, it's gutted basically. You will have, there's bits in here still, but you just drag them out. That's a bit of cod roe right there. I suppose you could eat that. I never have personally. I wouldn't know really what to do with it, but, and there we go. That's completely gutted now. Everything's out. So this is the way you could do it on the beach. I normally would, but I've left it to show you on the video how to gut one. So when you're down the beach, do this process, empty the guts out ASAP, and that's it. That's ready. Give it a wash out with the seawater, bring it home, and you've got the fish like this, ready to fillet. What I've done here now, I've changed the camera angle. If I sit the fish up, this is the side of the fish, as you can see. That's the head end, and you've got the main part of the body here. What I'm going to do is lay it so the top of the fish is facing us. I'll try and get the best shot on the camera as possible. If you look, you've got a sort of a line in the fish right there. I don't know if you can see that on the video. I think you can. You've got a line, and what you need to do with the knife is follow it along that line, keeping it on this side of the fin, the dorsal fin right there. You want to angle the knife in towards the fish. So say if that's your knife flat right there, lift it up to that angle and basically start roughly there on the line, angle it in towards the fish, angle it that way down and slice, and as you can see, that's going in nicely. Keep the knife angled down, otherwise you will lose the meat on it, and follow it all the way along. This is a bit awkward on the camera because the fish is a bit long, but follow it all the way along. When you get to this point towards the second fin there, just before you come to that fin, push it right through the fish. As you push it through, you'll feel the backbone. You want to be this side of the backbone, not below it. So push it through and it'll come out. I'll have to lift the camera up to show you this. It comes out of just above that fin, that side. You want it as close to this fin as possible so you don't lose any meat. From that point there, try and get the camera at a good angle. Basically, you want the knife to be twisted at that angle, like this, keeping it down towards the backbone. And just slowly, not much pressure, bring it along and keep it angled downwards off the tail. As you can see there, I will lift the camera in a minute, that's a good chunky fillet starting there. When down and it's like translucent, you can see the backbone here. So what you do now, you need to keep your knife at this angle all the time. I'll try and point it towards the camera so you can see. That's flat, you want to keep your knife at that sort of angle. So lift it a bit, keep your knife that way, and just slice along. Really take your time with this. If you've never done it, it is a bit fiddly. Once you've done it a few times, you get the hang of it. To be honest though, I've not done this for a while on a cod. So hopefully I'll get a do a good job here for you to show you how to do it yourselves. I'm hoping you got a good view. But you just keep at that angle and just keep going slowly, take your time and going against the bones. You don't want to waste anything. And what I'll do now is go right up along the head, up there. The next part, you've got the pectoral fin right there. I'll try and lift the fish so to show you can see better. Pectoral fin there, you want the knife to come in under this at an angle. So you bring the knife in here, like that. Hopefully you can see that okay. Slice in at an angle and go up towards the throat that way. I don't think you can see very well there. Hang on a sec. Up at an angle like that. Keep the knife at an angle. Go up that way towards there. And you want to curl it back this way, around the head, at an angle, pointing that way into the fish. Right, I'll cut this now, around there. Right, I'll do this cut now, and I'll show it you after I've done it. Like this, up along the head. Keep the knife angled in. The same up around the throat. As you can see now, we've got the bones here, look. That's the bottom fillet, that's the top fillet. The knife needs to stay above these bones. Hopefully you can see that line of bones. Angle it downwards. You can hear it as well. On the ribs. I'm not a fishmonger, not at all, don't claim to be. I'm not an expert at this, but I get enough meat off the fish to make it worthwhile doing. You don't want to be wasting the meat. Well, I'll pop the knife through the bottom there. Slice it up. You can see we've got a really nice chunky fillet here now coming. And this, I have lost a bit of meat there, look. You want to try not to do that. But, like I said, not a fishmonger. I'm just doing my best. Keep angling the knife towards the ribs. And just go slow. Right down like this. Here now you can actually, it's a bit difficult on this last section here. What you can do is pull. As you can see, that's the fillet off. All you gotta do is cut the skin down here and the skin there. Move the fish out of the way for a minute. And there's your cod fillet or codlin fillet right there. What we're gonna do now is trim this up, get rid of the skin here. Tidy that edge up, tidy the tail up. I've changed the angle of the camera a little. What you want to do is, we don't have to do this, it just tidies the fillet up a little. Don't go crazy, you don't want to waste fish, obviously, you don't want to waste the meat. But you can come along there, slicing down here, take that off, gets a nice finish there. And the same with the belly skin, you're not going to eat this. I'm going to actually skin this in a second. But for a prepared fillet, it's just nice to square it off. It looks more presentable. You do need a sharp knife for this though. Right, I'll lift the camera up. You can see there, that's like prime codlin fillet there. It's some, look, you're not going to beat it. As you can see, there's plenty of meat on there. I'll show you the fish itself. You'll be able to see what I mean. You can see the backbone right through there. This is what you want to have the finish like. I've lost a little bit of meat there, a fraction. This is all bone, so that's gone pretty well, considering I've done it for nearly a year on a codlin. And I don't generally take too many fish. There's a video of a bass that I did on the channel. That was the last fish I actually prepared. I'm going to show you how to debone the fillet. You have a row of pin bones running all the way down here. The stop roughly there. So what we'll do, I'll show you how to pin bone it. There's two ways of doing this. Personally, I cut a V in the fillet of fish and I peel the pin bones out. Or you can use tweezers and you can pull the pin bones out. That's personal preference. But I'll show you the way that I do it now. Right, to get these pin bones out, the run along here, you can feel them with your finger, you catch them as you go. The stop around there, I can't feel any more there now. So from there onwards, back that is boneless. It's going to be a bit awkward to show you on the video because the way I got the camera set up. But what you want to do, come as close to them as you can, like this, and turn your knife at that angle. I'll try and turn that fillet that way. Your knife is next to the bones there, but you want to lay it at that angle, and you want to go down into the fillet at that angle, and you do the same on this side. You come down at that angle. So, but, and technically, you're cutting a V into it. I'll have to probably take it slightly off camera to do this, but then I'll show you before I peel it out. Don't press hard either. Literally, the knife is doing the work, not you. You try and force it into this fillet, you're just going to take out too much. So just take your time with this part. There's nothing worse than you take a big bite of that battered fish and you get a big bone in your mouth. You want to get every bone out. Right, to try and show you. I've gone down the side there, look. The pin bones are in this. There's the bones, right there. And the same that side, look. At the front here, if you pinch right next to the skin and pull, well, that's one of the bones there, look, just come out. And just keep going. And hopefully, if it goes to plan, it'll all come out in one strip. So right there, there's a bone. Pinch next to the skin and pull. And it comes out like this. Stop about there. To check there. There's one more bone. If we slice this off here, there is now, you can see the skin underneath there. That's a deboned fillet. There is no bones left there at all. This is fully deboned. The rib cage is left on the fish, which is there. Hopefully you can see that. The rib cage is left on the fish, right in here. We didn't take that off with the fillet. And now the pin bones are gone. This is fully deboned. So that's how you fillet and debone it. Obviously, we're using this meat for batter. So what you need to do is take the skin off next. I did used to struggle with this, but when you do the skinning, I'll show you now on the video, you don't actually, the knife doesn't do the work. You just hold the knife still, you hold the skin, and you wiggle back and forth. I'll show you now. You come to the tail end here, and what you do, leave a little gap there. So you got, what you want to do is leave a bump of meat, just a fraction. You can see it's like, I don't know, 6-7 mil. When you cut into here now, go in gently so you don't go through the skin, just like this. Now what you can do, get the knife in, finger behind the knife and hold the meat. Slice in. That look, right there, that's what you want, don't go too far. That look is right against the skin, right there. You don't want to go too deep. So you get your knife back in at that angle, like this. Keep the knife pointing down towards the board. Now what you want to do is grab the skin, pull the skin tight, slide your knife forward, and slide your knife back, keeping it flat to the skin. Like this. If I stop a sec, you can see there, look, there's a little tiny fraction of meat there, but that's hardly anything. That skin's clean. And this is what you want to do all the way along the fish. But you need to keep this knife pointing downwards. Just hold the skin there and stretch the skin this way. Pull it that way and your knife pushes this way. I'm sorry if this video's a bit draggy, but I just want to show you properly. You don't want to waste it, do you? You've been out a lot of planning to get it. So now I'm pulling the skin. I'm not actually doing anything with a knife. I'm literally just pulling the skin. So hold the skin, hold the knife down at that angle, pull the skin and move it left to right like this. Right, skin is right there. There's hardly any meat on there. There's a little bit here. That's just lack of experience. I've not done it for a while, but I'm happy with that. Get rid of the skin. And now, that's de-skinned, deboned, ready to batter. So that's it. It looks a bit messy, but you can portion this up now. That's entirely up to you. You could just chop it in half. That is probably what you get in a chippy. It's the size of your hand. That's probably 6-7 inches long right there. So that's a nice fillet there to batter, and you got a nice little chunky fillet here to batter. Obviously it's not chip shop standard. I'm not a fishmonger, like I said earlier, and I'm just doing the best I can. There's no point killing these fish if you can't make the most of the meat. It's just a total waste and it's a shame. Well, now it's all done, it's fully deboned and all the skin's off, this is ready to be battered. So that's the next part coming. I just wanted to say quick, now that side's done, the other side is exactly the same. You lay it down and just do what you did on the other side on this side. It is a bit more fiddly because the fish is completely flat to the board, but you do exactly the same. Come along it all and literally do not rush it. If you rush it, you will mess it up and you will lose a lot of meat. There is literally no rush at all. Take your time, nice sharp knife, and keep it angled down towards the bones at that angle, so you can cut in at that angle back and forth. And don't put loads of pressure, just let the knife do the work. Get this side off, and this side, I'll probably do another video on it for fish fingers, maybe something like that. And this one will be your normal battered cod that you get from the chip shop with some homemade chips. Well, anyway, I hope you enjoyed the video. I hope it's helped you out. If you can, give the video a like, subscribe to the channel, and I'll see you in the next one.